Hey everybody, gonna have a go at the daisy, or coneflower, or echinacea, whatever it is. Well, it's all three of those, basically. I'm gonna start off with this top flower, and then hopefully get through it fairly quickly. That's what I'm going to concentrate on too. I've selected a whole range of oranges and slightly goldy type colours into browns. I've got some browns here, and then for my leaves, I've got some whites and quite a lot of lilacs and light purples into light blues, light greens, light pinks, and some whites, obviously. Okay, so first thing I'm going to have a go at is this top cone. So I've got some parchment paper here, which I'm just going to So, when we look at the actual picture, a lot of this area here is all in brown. So I'm going to cut this brown out in one piece, and then I'm going to stick these individual bits on. But I'm going to cut that all out. So what I need to do first is just to work out where that brown is. So I just look at my picture, keep referring back to my colour picture, and basically draw around the area that I want with one big block of brown, dark brown. I'm drawing these pieces that come down in a different colour on, because I'm going to cut them out individually. So once I've put my brown piece on, they won't be visible anymore. I mean, I can still peel it out and draw it around, but it's just as easy just to do it at this stage, draw them on. A lot of these pieces, it doesn't particularly matter, as long as they're roughly the right sort of size and shape, it doesn't matter. So I don't really need to stick completely to the plan. Just lost my way a bit there, so I'm going to come over here and keep drawing around. See what's going on in this corner. This is brown as well. Okay, so that's gone all the way around. So now I'm going to use my piece of spare parchment paper to draw that out. Just having a feel on my parchment paper, one side's slightly rougher than the other. It's easier to draw on the slightly rougher side. So this bit, I'm not going to be doing any of those. Yes, I am, because I need them. I was going to say I wasn't going to do any of those, but I do need those to draw on, because this will be the pattern that I'll use again. Okay. And make life a little bit easier when I'm cutting out. I'm just going to cut round this. There we go. Get that out of the way. So that's what I'm cutting round. Just going to pull your sleeves up. Sleeves aren't in the way. No, it's not big enough, so I can't use that. So it have to be that. Okay, so because it's This has got lines on, so I kind of want those lines fairly straight, otherwise it's just gonna distract, I think. So there we go. That's where I'm going from. Hold, so it's not going to slide around. I'm not wasting too much off of it. Okay, so then it's just a little bit easier just to cut out the notches. A little bit jaggedy, a little bit fussy cutting, but it's going to cover a nice big area to start with. Gives a nice big jump into the project. Sometimes it's nice just to get a nice big wad down. Can get bogged down in little very fiddly bits sometimes. You do find that this does move around a little bit when you're cutting out, so I'm not going to be absolutely accurate when I put it down, but it really doesn't matter. You're just covering area and it's roughly the right shape. So it's going to be fine. Peel that back and just try and work out where it is. Sort of there. As you can see, it's not quite on all of my lines, but that, as I said, I'm not too worried about that. That's going to be absolutely fine. Okay, so I'm going to seal this down now. already started to cut a few of my little bits out. So we can start to arrange. I'm going to put it up so I can see where it's got to go, roughly. So that's kind of in there. And this one just goes across the top here. My eye's not terribly hot at the moment because I've just turned it on, so it does take a little while to heat up a bit more. So I'm just leaving it on for a little bit longer, that's fine. Okay, so this is what I'm left with now after I've cut those bits out. So we'll carry on. It's getting a little bit brighter now. So cut the next one out of this. So February plans are already, patterns are all ready to go. It needs a clean, obviously, because it's pulling things up. Right, so carry on. That's okay, so I'm going to use that on this. Put my biggest bits in first. And you can just kind of almost arrange things around them. Don't have to be absolutely smack on. Just see where that should go. So that's about there. And then all the little dotty bits, I'm just going to pop around it. heart shape, it's fine. Back up again. So rather than doing all the dots, because it's a bit boring, I'm going to go on to the bits above. So again, I'm just going to just pencil out the area I'm going to do for you, so you can see it a bit easier. So that's where I'm going. There, because it's then just easier to kind of winkle pick these bits out. Rather than doing it in one whole strip. That doesn't want to come out, there we go. Peel my backing off. It's not stuck, so I'm just gonna give it an eye of that iron down. Camera back a little bit. There you go, so you can see a bit more of the mess. got no dogs in here this morning, so I'm afraid there's no no distracting noises. Just me and my scissors. Okay, so that's just gonna fit in behind there, just to give that little top bit of highlighting. It's starting to build up. So I'm going to come down over here now. Be the last bit I do with you guys, and then I shall finish off the top, and then we shall go on to some leaves. Not leaves, petals. Okay, I'm just gonna put this bit in here as well. Cut this down a bit. Great big bit. Decide what colour I'm going to go with. I'm going to go back to this. A small bit, so I'm just going to cut it out as one piece. Work out what I've done. I'm not actually going to bother to put that bit in the middle because this bit of fabric has got this bulge on here, and I think that's going to work fine anyway. No need to make work for yourself. I am just going to do this bit up here though, because I just want that highlighted bit. Use this again. Up, slot that under there. Okay, so you can kind of see where we're going with this. I'm going to carry on and finish off this top area, and then we'll come back and start doing some of the petals. Okay then, bye for now.